Prepare the tools, ruler, cutter, brush, wood, and so on. Polish the original mold and fix it to the board. Coat the original mold surface with release agent Vaseline. Choose the right parting mold line. Normally, the mold can be made in two pieces and also can be multi-pieces for complex products. Position the mold line on the top of the mold when drawing and run around the face and eyes of the mold as possible as you can. Pile up the clay under the mold line. The clay cannot be too hard and it cannot be any gaps between the mold and the clay. Smooth the surface of the clay with your moistened fingers. After fixing the clay, dig in the holes evenly on the clay to make a latch. The latch can gather the silicone rubber mold much better and avoid the dislocation between two pieces of silicone rubber mold. The latch should be about 1 centimeter away from the mold. Remove the surplus clay. According to the complicated structure of the size of the products, we choose the type of silicone rubber which has a low viscosity and hardness like Hongye HY.628 silicone rubber. Mix silicone rubber and curing agent evenly. The proportion of the curing is 2% to 5%. Then put them into the vacuum container to pump the air out of the silicone rubber. Vacuum pumps should be minus 0.1 millibar, which will avoid the mold from bubbles and guarantee quality, or you can reduce the catalyst if you don't have a vacuum machine, which release the air bubbles by extending the curing time. After vacuum pumping, brush the first layer of silicone rubber evenly on the mold. The first layer silicone rubber should be thinner than 1 millimeter, which is to cover the mold and the clay thinly. Brush the second layer of silicone rubber till the first one is cured, about 15 minutes. The proportion of curing agent in second layer of silicone rubber should be higher than the first one. It would spend 5 to 8 minutes to cure. After brushing the second or the third layer of silicone rubber, cover the gauze. When the silicone starts flowing, the gauze can increase the tension and strength of the mold. According to the size of the product, add one more layer of gauze. Generally, it will not cover more than two layers of gauze. After the silicone cured, the outer mold from gypsum can be made. Knife to prepare the cardboard well, then fix the cardboard around the original mold without any gap. Pour the silicone rubber, which is mixed evenly, into the mold. Remove the cardboard after the gypsum cured. Revise the age of the gypsum mold and clean the grease on the other side of the cardboard. Repeat the steps to make the silicone mold and gypsum outer mold for the other side. Release the mold. Remove the cardboard after the outer mold cured. Release the whole gypsum mold of the silicone mold. Then check and amend the silicone mold by the scissors and revise gypsum mold. Now you get the perfect silicone mold now, and please put it into production after 24 hours.